we have various types of relationship. We have family, we have friendship, we have business associates, we have mentorship relationship, and we have love relationship. So I'll be taking these types of relationship one after the other so that we can have an in-depth knowledge and have a solid foundation to build upon as we move on. All right, go with me to the first, which is family relationship. So the family relationship is a relationship which is obtained by default. That means you just found yourself there and there's nothing you can do about that. But the kind of relationship which is also the second part of the family is marriage. And this is a kind of relationship whereby you have the right to make your own choice, and anything you do before you go into that marriage is going to actually tell. So the choices you make in life really goes a long way to determine what will come out of you, or the outcome you're going to make out of life. So the choices you also make in marriage will either make your marriage or mar your marriage. The sense of this is to initiate you into knowing what to do and not to do, so that the choices you make, perhaps you've made the wrong choice and that is telling on you, you can actually amend it before going there. Or if you are there already, then you have to pray to God so that He can see you through. So that's the kind of family relationship. The first family relationship is the one whereby you got by default, and then the second is the one whereby you made by choice. So the second type of relationship is friendship relationship. While I was growing up, I adopted a maxim which says, don't let your friends choose you, but you choose your friends. And since then, I've been making the choice of friends. Proverbs chapter 22 verse 17 says, iron sharpens iron, and so a man the countenance of his friend. If you find out that your circle of influence, that means the circle of friends you keep, the first 10 people in your life, has no influence in your life, has no positive impact you are making in your life, then withdraw your circle. Withdraw your circle, withdraw from some, and hide people who has positive impact to make in your life. So the other type of relationship is the business associate relationship. It's a relationship whereby you find yourself in a community of business associates, whereby you have to relate with them, interpersonal relationship. You have to do what the organization asks you to do, and you have to make sure that you perform your duties and obligations with diligence and discipline and determination. And as much as you have to obey rules, and as much as you have to move and relate with people in an organization, whenever you find out that they laid down principles and rules of the organization is against your belief, then what you have to do? You have to prayerfully quit that kind of associate. You have to prayerfully quit that kind of relationship, because though we are in this world, we are not of this world, and we have a promising future. We have a hope of glory. Christ is in us, which is the hope of glory. So if you find out that their beliefs is not going to work in line with what you believe or what God says, then the best thing for you to do is to prayerfully opt out, and God will create a job for you. So the fourth type of relationship is the mentorship relationship. You know, recently I took a session on that on our WhatsApp group. Our mentorship relationship is a very wide one, whereby if I want to talk about it, it can also take another episode entirely. But I'll just brief you. A mentor is a teacher, a guide, a counselor. A mentor is trusted. A mentor is someone you can confide in. A mentor is a good example. A mentor is such that can correct you when you go wrong. A mentor is not a tormentor. There's a very big difference between a mentor and a tormentor. A tormentor torments you in every ways, plays with your feelings, plays with your emotions, can fumble with your body, can do any sort of things to you. But as a mentor is there to guide you. A mentor is there to correct you. And in mentorship relationship, you can see examples, various examples in the scriptures. Esther needed a Mordecai to guide her. Ruth needed a Naomi. Saul needed an Ananias. Barnabas needed a Paul. The disciples needed a master. And you need a mentor. So with that mentorship kind of relationship, you can be rest assured that the course of your life will be channeled in the right direction, because a mentor is such that has gone through the path whereby you want to tread and knows virtually everything or almost everything about that course of action. Mentorship in your relationship is very, very important if you must lead a successful life and have a successful relationship. I'm currently preparing an ebook on that concerning the last teaching on mentorship and relationship. You can kindly send a message to the number on the screen and you're gonna get your ebook. So now I want to talk about the love relationship. You must understand that everybody needs somebody. And that's why the scripture says two are better than one, for they have a good reward for their labor. And Solomon says, I charge ye, daughters of Jerusalem, that ye awaken not my love before it pleases. So also, there's a time that you don't just have to smile and just be laughing when you begin to hear all those sweet words and stuff like that, and then you give in just so cheaply. King Solomon was trying to make us understand that there is time for everything. And also, we do not have to awaken love at the wrong time. Because if you awaken love at the wrong time, it's either going to demoralize you, going to make you imbalanced, going to affect you, going to destroy you. So therefore, I urge you to wait for your time. So in conclusion, a romantic relationship is for two who are joined together by God and recognized by men. In other words, a marriage type of relationship. Alright, now we've come to the end of the episode for today. And then in the next episode, I'll be telling you the tips on how to sustain a good relationship. Kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching. God bless you. See you next week. Bye. Thank you.